Point value is a double. Top 8 answers on the board. We asked 100 women, name something of Steve Harvey's that you would love to see.
His bald head.
His bald head.
His wife.
His wife. Pass the play.
We're playing.
We gonna play. Chad, we ask 100 women, name something of Steve Harvey's you'd love to see.
His house.
His house.
I said house, not bedroom.
Yeah, no, it's bedroom. That's what you want to see, that bedroom. Janelle, talk to 100 women, name something of Steve Harvey's that you'd love to see.
Your wardrobe.
The wardrobe. Jill, talk to 100 women, name something of Steve Harvey's you'd love to see.
His paycheck.
Yeah. Show me the money.
Good answer. That's the reason I'm here. The paycheck. Yeah. Adam, talk to 100 women, name something of Steve Harvey's you'd love to see.
I'd love to see your cars, Steve.
The cars! Yeah. Yeah, women don't care about that. That's a guy thing. Cars is a guy thing. All right, Irene, one strike. We ask 100 women, name something of Steve Harvey's that you'd love to see.
I'd like to see where you go for a vacation.
Good! Girl, you better know it. Where we going on vacation? All right, Chad, we got 2 strikes. Ferguson family can steal. Talk to 100 women. Name something of Steve Harvey's you'd love to see.
His muscles?
His muscles. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. It's something to see under here.
Oh, yeah.
Other than my stomach, if you would just not focus on the midsection area, the rest of that boy is nice. Yeah. Yeah. Muscles!
There you go, there you go.
I like it.
Yeah, you didn't know that, did you? Yeah, you didn't know that. Oh, yo, it's frogs up under there. I just tell you, you just can't get in here. They down there. They move around, they get funky with it. Yeah, I ain't Terry Crews, but hell, Terry Crews ain't me.
Yeah.
Hello. Yeah. I'm sorry. All right, Janelle, 2 strikes. Gotta be careful. Ferguson's can steal. 100 women. Name something of Steve Harvey's you'd love to see.
Your jewelry watch?
Yeah, good answer. Lee, yeah.
Your jewelry. Oh. We asked 100 women, name something of Steve Harvey's you would love to see.
I'm sorry, Steve, but we think we want to see your private parts.
Yeah. Get your singles out, lady. I'm sorry, Steve, but your private parts. Find 2 people that want to see it. Damn. Well, that's a kick in the teeth. We couldn't even find 2 people want to see my ass naked. Well, see you next, Steve. Yeah. Number eight. That's not happening. No, six.
That sexy smile.
Four. Let's go. Got the top seven answers on the board. Fill in the blank. Grandma put real pot in Grandpa's... Yes.
Pipe.
Yeah. In his pipe. Fill in the blank. Grandma put real pot in Grandpa's pot pie, and he blanked all night.
Hallucinated.
Hallucinated. All right, let's go. I'm Steve Harvey. I'm Fly.
You're Fly.
Greatest game show host on the planet
yes.
right now.
Yes! Yes, you are.
Number two behind Alex Trebek.
Aww.
Alex Trebek.
Aww.
I like that game. I respect him. I really respect him, so I got to play number two.
Yeah, that's
all right, you ready? Grandma put real pot in Grandpa's pot pie, and he blanked all night.
Slept.
Slept. All right, DJ. Grandma put real pot in Grandpa's pot pie, and he blanked all night.
Laughed.
Laughed. Yeah. Hey, Trinette. Grandma put real pot in Grandpa's pot pie, and he blanked all night.
He had the munchies.
Yeah!
He had the munchies.
Yeah!
Yeah! Good job.
Good job, sir.
Hey, I don't want to prejudge nobody. But they done gave four answers, and they the top four. We're going to put a stop to this here, because I can assure you. What church y'all go to, Miss Katie?
Calvary Chapel.
Yeah, see, she ain't finna know this. Grandma put real pot, that's weed, in Grandpa's pot pie, and he blanked all night.
He stayed awake all night.
Yeah, see. So you gon' get an X now.
Up there.
No, ma'am. No, Miss Katie, that's smoking weed and staying up all night is not gonna be up there. No. Stay up all night.
Oh,
all right, now Eshell, fill in the blank. Grandma put real pot in Grandpa's pot pie, and he blanked all night.
He cooked.
He cooked.
He cooked all night.
He that probably happened though. You know, you've been smoking weed, just being there just frying chicken. Get some more chicken in here. Ian, we gotta be careful now. We got two strikes. Kenny family can steal. Grandma put real pot in Grandpa's pot pie and he blanked all night.
Talked all night.
Yeah. He talked all night. DJ, we got two strikes. DJ is a professional cheerleader coach for national pro team. Grandpa put real pot in Grandpa's pot pie, and he blanked all night.
Pooped.
Pooped. First they get more.
Really? Pooped. Okay, but it's one answer left. All right, here we go. Fill in the blank. Grandma put real pot in Grandpa's pot pie, and he blanked all night.
Scratched.
Scratched. Scratched!
Come on.
fill in the blank. Grandma put real pot in Grandpa's pot pie, and he blanked all night.
Steve, we're gonna say, got frisky.
He got frisky! Number seven. Top eight answers on the board. Here we go. Name something of Steve Harvey's you'd like to touch.
His bald head.
His bald head. Pass the play. Michael, how you doing, man?
I'm doing good, Brother Steve.
Yeah, good, good, good. Let's start with this pastoral jacket.
Oh. Yeah. Yes, thank you.
Yeah. This is normally what pastors wear on their anniversary. Have you ever been to a Baptist church when preachers have anniversaries, they wear outfits like this?
Yes, sir.
That's right, man.
Yes, sir.
Good, good.
Jesus gave it to me.
Jesus gave it.
I prayed and it was on sale. So Jesus gave it to me.
Yeah. I like it though. That's pretty sharp, yes, sir, there, Pastor. Yes, sir, yes, sir. You knew you was coming to see me, didn't you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
See, they get butted up when they come to see Steve. Uncle Steve been putting it on them for a long time.
Yes, sir.
So they get butted up. Woo! All right, so. Come on, let's play. Oh, hi, Miss Norma. Name something of Steve Harvey's you'd like to touch.
His nice suits.
Yeah, good answer. Good answer.
His nice suits.
Good answer. Good answer.
Danny, name something of Steve Harvey's you'd like to touch.
I think somebody might like to touch your butt, Steve. Somebody. Somebody.
Good answer. Good answer.
Touch his butt. Yeah. Hey, Michelle. Name something to Steve Harvey's you'd like to touch.
I like to touch that mustache.
Be careful, little girl. Mustache! Yeah! Yeah! Michael, name something of Steve Harvey's you'd like to touch.
I think that there's somebody somewhere that would want to touch your private area.
Not me.
I'm just trying to win. I'm thinking on behalf of those that ain't converted.
Put your hands on me! Dana, name something of Steve Harvey's you'd like to touch.
Your lips, Steve.
Hey, watch out, Dana. What you been at the house thinking about, man? Lips! Miss Norma, name something Steve Harvey's you'd like to touch.
Well, then I'll just have to touch your hand.
You have to touch my hand? Yeah. Danny, name something of Steve Harvey's you'd like to touch.
I think I would like to grab hold of your wallet, Steve.
His wallet. That's a dollar. Michelle, one answer left. You can clear the board. Name some of Steve Harvey's you'd like to touch.
Your nice car, Steve.
Good answer.
Good answer.
One of them cars. Point values are double. Top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 women, name a food that excites you as much as sex.
Chocolate.
Chocolate.
We're gonna play, Steve.
All right, Priscilla. Talk to 100 women. Name a food that excites you as much as sex.
How about some pizza?
Can't be up there. Pizza. Cute Quinn?
Yes.
We ask 100 women, name a food that excites you as much as sex.
I love me some ice cream.
Yes!
So you gotta bring some ice cream.
Ice cream. Yeah! Yourself. We ask 100 women, name a food that excites you as much as sex.
Cherries.
Oh, you close, boy. You thought I said, name a food that excites you like it's sex. Then he said, give me that cherry. I know that's right, boy. You better understand. Cherry! Oh, Harvey, you ain't gonna get this either. Because we ask 100 women, name a food that excites you as much as sex.
Well, my wife's pregnant, so cake.
Hey,
cake. Oh. Oh, don't worry. Oh, don't worry. She gonna have one. Two strikes. Point of family can steal.
I'm gonna say lobster.
Yeah.
Good. Big stuff.
Yeah. Lobster. We ask 100 women, name a food that excites you as much as sex.
French fries.
Huh?
French fries.
French fries. Number seven.
Tacos.
What? Six.
Creme brulee and mustard.
What? Five.
Cookies.
Well, we close. Number four. Point values are double. Top four answers on the board. Name someone you hope you'll only see once a year.
Taxman.
Taxman, huh? Pass the plate. They're gonna play. All right, Miss Beverly, name someone you hope you'll only see once a year.
How about the doctor, Steve?
The doctor. Will, name someone you hope you'll only see once a year.
No disrespect, but in-laws. Not mine, but the 100 people. Not mine.
I think his answer is spot on.
No.
The in-laws. One answer left. Name someone you hope you'll only see once a year.
Steve, I am going to say, Santa Claus. Yes. Don't want to spend money.
Santa Claus. Top six answers on the board. Name something the church could get that might suddenly make a man want to attend.
Strippers.
Strippers. Tim is a pastor.
Sorry, Tim.
Yeah. But I'm doing this here, yeah. Then I looked over there and went, oh, hell. Strippers! Top six answers on the board. Name a reason a man thinks his wife looks as young as she did the day he married her.
Alcohol.
That's the best answer I've ever heard that might not be up there. Well, damn, that's a good answer. Alcohol! Give me Sean, give me Kobe. I don't know what y'all just did. I was trying to focus on this card. Top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 married men. If you want to have a good marriage, name something you and your spouse should do every day.
Sex.
You better, man, I wish, yes, sex.
Talk to me.
Charles. Pass or play?
We'll play.
Corby?
Yes, sir.
How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great.
Good, good. What do you do?
I am a children's pastor.
You just pastor kids?
I do. Yeah.
That's about the level I'd have to go in. I didn't know you could just go be a kid's pastor.
I'm a big kid myself, Steve.
That's pretty good. Well, let's play the game. 100 married men, if you want to have a good marriage, name something you and your spouse ought to do every day.
You need to kiss, Steve.
You need to kiss every day. Mr. Dwayne, 100 married men, if you want to have a good marriage, name something you and your spouse ought to do every day.
Communicate.
Communicate. Hey, Amanda, we talked to 100 married men. If you want to have a good marriage, something you and your spouse ought to do every day.
Go on dates.
Go on dates. Marty, what do you do, buddy?
I'm a blessed man. I've got a wife, three beautiful children. My middle son has autism. The doctors told him, an expert said, that he may never talk or learn in school. And he has graduated high school last year.
That's because they don't know.
God has a different plan.
They don't know.
That's right.
People don't know.
That's right.
All right, Marty. If you want to have a good marriage, name something you and your spouse.
And psychologists say that you need to touch each other.
Need to touch each other. Yeah. We need to touch. All right, Corbin, 100 men. If you want to have a good marriage, name something you and your spouse should do every day. You got two strikes. You got to be careful. Mariano family can steal.
Steve, I'm going to say that you need to eat together. Eat together.
Eat together. Come on. 100 married men, if you want to have a good marriage, name something you and your spouse should do every day.
We're going to say help with the chores.
Anybody see it? Help with the chores. Number 7. What? We're getting close to the end at that point, folks. 6.
Go to work.
5.
Hold back complaints.
Oh, yeah. 4. Top 7 answers on the board, ladies. Name something Grandpa has dreams of Judge Judy doing to him.
Giving him a divorce.
Giving him a divorce. Miss Thelma.
Having sex.
Having sex. What else? Joe?
Make him dinner.
Make him dinner. Thank you, Joe. Make him dinner.
Oh!
Pass it.
We're gonna play, Steve.
We're gonna play. Janet, what do you do for a living?
Well, I'm a sales manager for SCI, Services Corporation International. We're the largest death care providers in North America.
Death care?
Yes.
What you mean?
I mean, cemetery and mortuary arrangements and prearrangements. We assist families who've had a loss. And more importantly, Steve, more importantly, we help them pre-plan, Steve.
No, I don't want you pre-planning nothing. I ain't asking you nothing. Didn't you see me walk off?
Steve!
I don't talk to people like you.
Well, we all have an appointment, Steve.
No, you don't know when it is.
I don't know when it is, but we gotta be ready at all times.
What you mean? Well, who is you? Who died and made you president of the damn death club?
I'm the messenger, Steve. Just
you're not
messenger.
A messenger.
Oh,
you
Steve.
Just work down there. You're probably on commission.
Oh,
selling plots and funerals and casket fabrics and all
Steve.
That. I don't give a damn what my casket look like. Hell, I ain't gonna see it.
Steve, it's for your protection.
I'm dead. How are you protecting people who are dead? You die so you can be worry free.
But you don't want to leave your family with worries. Hey, Steve, it's a tough job, but somebody's got to do it, huh?
Don't nobody want to hear your slogan. Miss Thelma, what do you do?
Yes, nothing.
She said, yes, nothing. That's what this where I'm trying to get to, right here. Miss Thelma, yes, what do you do? Nothing.
Not to take my clothes off.
Miss Thelma, what's going on?
No, I turned 72, and I lived in Vegas.
Okay.
So then somebody asked, do you want to do a new post? I said, sure. Come and audition for the book. So I said, okay. Of course, I thought I wasn't going to make it. I was 72 years old. 2 days later, they called me and say, we want you to come down. You made your book. We want you to do some nude poses for Timeless Beauty.
Timeless
and
Beauty.
And here I am.
Wow. You did all that after 70.
Life begins at 70. Come on.
Wow. That's pretty good. All right, let's play.
Carrera.
Carrera. Mm-hmm. Oh, like the car?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Name something Grandpa has dreams of Judge Judy doing to him.
Tell him to go to jail.
Tell him to go to jail.
Good answer. Yeah.
Good answer, baby. Good answer.
Pull that out.
You can't believe that's up there. Go to jail. Miss Beverly, name something Grandpa has dreams of Judge Judy doing to him.
Telling him he's fired.
Telling him he's fired. All right, Will, we got one strike.
Yes,
name
sir.
Something Grandpa has dreams of Judge Judy doing to him.
Bathing him.
Bathing him. Come on, Judge. Jeanette, name something. Got two strikes. Got to be careful. Landgraf family can steal. Something Grandpa has dreams of Judge Judy doing to him.
Burying him, Steve? He's aging.
Yeah, he's aging. Yeah. I'm going over here. Hell, what you think? Ain't nobody saying this but her. Then no damn grandpa won't judge Judy to bury him. Bury him! Here I come, boys. Name something grandpa has dreams of Judge Judy doing to him.
Spank him.
Spank him? Number seven. Six. Five. Number one. Oh, God, I wish I was playing. All right, point value is a double. Ladies, top seven answers on the board. You know more Italian than you think. Give me a word in Italian.
Ciao.
Huh?
Ciao.
Ciao. Pass and play.
We're gonna play.
Oh, this is gonna be good. Oh, this is gonna be really good. Okay. Hey, you're gonna learn yourself something today. I don't know any of these. Megan, you know more Italian than you think. Give me a word in Italian.
Fettuccine.
Huh?
Yeah!
It's fettuccine.
Like a pasta.
I know what fettuccine is. That's Italian?
I think so. I hope so.
But they had that written on the box in the store.
You know more than you think.
Huh?
You know more Italian than you think. Right?
Sorry.
Only one strike, Sydney. You know more Italian than you think. Give me a word in Italian.
Spaghetti.
Good answer. Good answer.
Spaghetti. Oh, so you think spaghetti?
Spaghetti.
Really?
Yeah, try it. It's good.
Spaghetti.
I told you. Spaghetti.
Charlie, you know more Italian than you think. Give me a word in Italian.
Amore? Mi amore.
Amore! Oh. Harvey, man, you got two strikes. Sheevy family can steal. You know more Italian than you think. Obviously not, but... Give me a word in Italian.
Gucci.
Gucci?
Gucci.
Gucci. Okay, well, guess I ain't the only one don't know nothing. Gucci. You know more Italian than you think. Give me a word in Italian.
Pizza.
Pizza!
Yeah.
Pizza! Number 7.
Arrivederci.
Number 6.
Vino.
Okay, that's wine. 5.
Pasta.
Number 3.
Bella.
Let's get it on. Let's play Feud. Give me Nina. Give me Gia. Top 6 answers on the board, ladies. Here we go. Name a sexy fabric that makes a good stripper name.
Silk.
Silk. Hey, Nina.
Hi, Mr. Harvey.
How you doing?
I'm doing quite well. Very excited.
Where y'all from?
We reign from Maxton, North Carolina.
Yeah. All right, introduce everybody.
Yes. Well, beside me, I have my beautiful niece number 1, Shanice, my beautiful niece number 2, Sharae, my younger brother, we call him Little Johnny, but Johnny Hines, and my wonderful aunt, Sarah Williams.
Woo! All right, darling, you ready to play? Name a sexy fabric that makes a good stripper name.
I'm gonna say lace.
Yeah!
Lace! Good answer.
Lace! Sheree, name a sexy fabric that makes a good stripper name.
I'm gonna say velvet.
Woo!
Velvet.
Yeah.
It's one I'm waiting on. Y'all finna learn y'allself something now. Johnny.
Yo.
Come on, boy. Sexy fabric that makes a good stripper name.
Well, she might be from the hood, Steve, so
come on,
boy. I'm gonna say polyester, bro.
Polyester. Huh? Huh? You don't know. See, if you ain't from the hood, you don't know. This stripper's name, polyester. You don't, polyester. This is my dude right here. I told y'all. Before he said it, I said, y'all finna learn something. Because I know you don't know. When I saw a stripper, I went, yeah. My dude gonna have one for you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Let's do it.
Hey, Miss Sarah.
Hello, Steve.
Yes, ma'am. What do you do?
I'm a human resource specialist for Duke University Medical Center.
Okay, good. Come on, let's go. Name a sexy fabric that makes a good stripper name.
I'm gonna say spandex.
Yeah!
Good answer. Good answer. Go ahead,
man. Ladies and gentlemen, spandex. All right, we only got one strike now. Nina, give me a sexy fabric that makes a good stripper name.
I'm gonna say jersey knit.
Ooh, that's good.
Yeah, yeah, we're gonna go with that. Jersey knit. Yes, yes. Jersey Network.
That's all right. You ain't never been to strip club before.
Not dance.
No. I know, but ain't nobody in there named Jersey Nick. Ain't nobody finna do that, baby. No.
It's up there.
Jersey Nick.
That's all we got.
Shanice.
Yes.
2 strikes. Motto family can steal. Name a sexy fabric that makes a good stripper name.
Mesh.
Okay. That's good. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Mesh.
Ladies and gentlemen, mesh.
Yeah. That's okay.
Name a sexy fabric that makes a good stripper name.
Satin.
five.
That's here.
Point values are double. Top 8 ounces on the board. Name a famous man who might be described as bald and beautiful.
Steve Harvey.
Man. Just anywhere on the board. Please. I know I'm not attractive. But just let two people think I am. Steve Harvey. Thank you so much. Thank you. Oh my God, thank you. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Father God, thank you. Keep clapping, Valerie. Point values are double. Top 6 answers on the board. Name an excuse a man gives his wife for coming home late that she doesn't buy.
My car got stuck.
My car got stuck, yeah.
Working late.
Working late.
Wait. Good play, Steve.
Good play. Samantha, an excuse a man gives his wife for coming home late and she don't buy.
He fell asleep.
He fell asleep. Hey, Jasmine, give me an excuse that a man gives his wife for coming home late and she don't buy.
He went out to eat with his friends.
He went to eat with his friends. Nina, an excuse a man gives his wife for coming home late and she doesn't buy it.
He went to visit his family?
Went to visit his family. Vicky, 2 strikes, gotta be careful. Pasol's family can steal.
He had an appointment?
Had an appointment. Name an excuse. Hey, you quit asking him. You know this one. Come on. You the one got the divorce. Come on, let's talk about what caused it. Name an excuse a man gives his wife. That's why we in here now. For coming home late. Me and you both done this, dog. That she doesn't buy. What is it?
Stuck in traffic.
Stuck in traffic. You doggone right. Yeah, stuck in traffic. I knew good how well he had that. Come on. Let's quit playing this game, bro. Come on. Number 6. I got some more you ain't got. Number 5. Yeah. Point values are triple. Top 4 answers on the board. Name something you leave on all night when your spouse is out of town.
Your clothes.
Your clothes.
Television.
Television. Renault, name something you leave on all night when your spouse is out of town.
The lights.
The lights. One answer left, Nicole.
Okay.
Name something you leave on all night when your spouse is out of town.
I'm gonna say the alarm. Yeah.
This is for the win. The alarm.
Good answer, Nicole.
Mike, 1 answer left. If it's there, your family wins the game, your family drives out of here in a brand new car. Name something you leave on all night when your spouse is out of town.
You know, Steve, I better leave that cell phone on when she's out of town.
Absolutely.
You better leave on the cell phone for the win. Misha, one answer left.
Yes.
If it's there, your family wins the game, your family drives out of here in a brand new car. But this time, Misha, you have two strikes. Yes. If it's not there, the other family can steal and they will win the game. Name something you leave on all night when your spouse is out of town.
I'm gonna say music.
This is for the win. Music! Top 8 answers on the board. Here we go. We ask 100 married people, what might you bring to bed with you when you're feeling romantic? Yeah, James.
Some sexy boxers.
Some sexy dumb boss.
Wine?
Wine. Pass the play.
You're going
to play. You're going to play. Richard, 100 married people. What might you bring to bed with you when you're feeling romantic?
How about some condoms, Steve?
You just coming there with a box in your hand? Condoms. Michelle, 100 married people, what might you bring to bed with you when you're feeling romantic?
Some lotion.
No. Oh, yes.
Lotion. Hey, talk to 100 married people, what might you bring to bed with you when you're feeling romantic?
Oh, you gotta bring that music.
Yeah.
That Barry White.
You gotta bring
that music.
Yeah.
Bring that, like I mean, like who?
Like Barry White.
Yeah. Barry
some
White.
Sade, you know.
Some Sade. Come on, Abe.
Oh, come on now.
Hey, what you know about that? The music.
Oh. I like that. Yeah.
Robert, this ought to be a good one for you. We talked to 100 married people. What might you bring to bed with you when you're feeling romantic, Robert?
Candles.
Yeah. Candles. Levanna, what might you bring to bed with you when you're feeling romantic?
Maybe you're feeling a little adventurous, some like chocolate or whipped cream.
Yeah. Yeah. Chocolate. Yeah. Richard? Talk to 100 married people. You married.
All right.
What might you bring to bed with you when you feeling romantic?
Steve, all right. I'm going to go with toys.
Good answer!
Good answer! Just want to clear.
I mean, when you say toys, Richard, what you talking about?
Steve.
What, you mean like Barbie doll, naked?
I'm done with it. If we can move on, we can. That's
all right,
good.
Let's go.
Yeah,
toys. Michelle, it's getting good. Now, what might you bring to bed with you when you feeling romantic?
A blindfold, Steve.
God. Hey, what the hell are you grinning so hard for? So, hey, let me ask you something, though. Because this your wife. So you mean to tell me you've been handcuffed and blindfolded?
Yes.
It's my sister, Steve.
Yeah.
Yeah. Blindfold. Well, we got two strikes, Abe. You gotta be careful. Kyle's family can steal.
A little feather duster, one of those feathers.
Boy. Yeah.
You know what that is, Steve.
A feather duster.
You know, little feathers, you know, the sexy feathers.
Feathers. We ask 100 married people, what might you bring to bed with you when you feeling romantic?
Steve, I'm gonna say birthday suit.
Yeah! Yeah! Your birthday suit. Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Top 8 answers on the board. Because it's hell, H-E-L-L, because it's hell, on your first morning there, you'll probably wake up next to who?
Satan.
Satan. Good. Pass or play?
We're gonna play.
You're gonna play. Joe, because it's hell on your first morning, you'll probably wake up next to who? Come on.
My ex.
You damn, your ex. Yes! Your ex. Because it's hell, on your first morning there, you probably wake up next to who?
My boss.
Your boss. Hey, Cynthia, because it's hell on your first morning there, you probably wake up next to who?
Your in-laws, Steve.
Your in-laws. In-laws. Hey, Connie. Because it's hell on your first morning there, you probably wake up next to who?
Hitler.
You damn sure will. Hitler. Okay, Kate, because it's hell on your first morning there, you'll probably wake up next to who?
I'm gonna go with my siblings.
She seems like a really nice girl. No, I am
a nice sister.
Watch, I don't think you're up there.
I better not.
Your sibling.
Oh. It's okay, good.
One strike, Joe. Because it's hell on your first morning there, you probably wake up next to who?
What about the IRS?
The IRS. The IRS.
Oh.
All right, Mike, we gotta be careful. We got two strikes. Mathis family can steal. Because it's hell on your first morning there, you probably wake up next to who?
A serial rapist.
Let's see if he's up there.
Yeah.
The serial guy. Oh. Hey, because it's hell on your first morning there, you probably wake up next to who?
Steve, we're gonna say a lawyer.
A lawyer. Number 8. 7.
My best friend.
Damn. 6. All right, ladies, top 8 answers on the board. Here we go. Name something an 80-year-old man might get rid of if he discovered the fountain of youth.
The pocket.
Give him a pocket!
His glasses.
His glasses.
His Kevin. Wife.
His wife. Yeah, you don't. Don't be trying to threaten him now. You done came up here and said this crazy ass answer. So his next answer was your wife. Your wife. You gonna pass?
Yes.
Sorry you had to go through this, Luke. Name something an 80-year-old man might get rid of if he discovered the Fountain of Youth.
Well, I mean, he wouldn't need this anymore, but a cane.
A cane! Hey, Natalie, if 80-year-old man might get rid of if he discovered the Fountain of Youth...
His medication!
His medication! Hey, Carissa, something an 80-year-old man might get rid of if he discovered the Fountain of Youth.
His dentures!
His dentures! Hey, Mark, something an 80-year-old man might get rid of if he discovered the Fountain of Youth.
He doesn't need that doctor anymore.
Doesn't need that doctor anymore. Hey, Bridget, something an 80-year-old man might get rid of if he discovered the Fountain of Youth.
His wheelchair.
His wheelchair. All right, we got two strikes. We got to slow down now, Luke. Come on. The Barrett family can steal. Be careful. Name something an 80-year-old man might get rid of if he discovered the Fountain of Youth.
His goofy clothes.
His goofy clothes. Yeah. Natalie, two strikes. Let's be careful. Barrett family can steal something 80-year-old man to get rid of if he discovered the Fountain of Youth.
His cream. You know, if he's old, he's trying to make, like, anti-aging cream.
Get rid of his cream. Yeah. Name something an 80-year-old man might get rid of if he discovered the Fountain of Youth.
We're gonna say hearing aid, Steve.
Hearing aid. Number eight.
Wayne Belly.
Four.
Gray hair.
Three. All right, Regina, we gotta be careful. We got two strikes. The Cedar family can steal. Tell me a place you go where you take off your clothes.
Slip and slide.
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on, let's go. Great answer.
Regina,
let me ask you something. I don't know about this kind of stuff. What is slip and slide? What is that?
You know, the one that we used to play Mr. Wiggle with?
Mr. Wiggle.
I didn't say it.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Wait.
The little wiggle that you go and you slide down.
You slide down Mr. Wiggle?
No, Mr. Wiggle is wiggling and wetting you while you're sliding.
Wait a minute. Mr. Wiggle is wetting you?
Yeah.
And then the slide?
Yeah, and the slide that you're sliding on.
Get it nice and lubed up,
Miss Regina,
eh?
what are you talking about?
No, Mr. Wiggle, it's...
I'm familiar with Mr. Wiggle.
Right, but it wiggles around to it wet wiggles, you.
Is it?
And it wets...
It wiggles around to wet you.
So that you can slide on the slide.
Lubricant. Yeah. The slip and slide.
What did you say?
The slip and slide.
No.
It's like a slip.
Okay, you shut up. So it's this thing, and it wiggles, and it wets you. Then when you get wet, what happens?
You slide.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Where are you going? Where are you sliding?
On the slip and slide, the little yellow mat. It's a yellow mat.
It's a yellow mat. There's a place where this happens?
On the grass.
On the grass?
Yes. Yeah.
What? This story is getting more and more interesting. So, Regina, Mr. Wiggles, he done got loose. Mr. Wiggles is just...
Yeah.
All over the place. Ooh. And you getting wet. And please don't look so distressed. You look unhappy. You said, go ahead.
Because you don't understand, and I thought everybody had, especially my age, would know about Mr. Wiggle.
I told you. Gene, I told you. I'm very familiar with Mr. Wiggle.
Oh.
I never called him that, but if that's... Oh. You
know. What did you call him?
Russell.
Oh, okay. Ours was Mr. Wiggle.
It's Russell the Wonder Muscle. Now you can call yours Mr. Wiggle if you want to. Mine is Russell the Wonder Muscle. When I was younger, he had a hip-hop name. I called him Notorious B.I.G. Notorious for short. But if you want to call me Mr. Wiggles, I'm comfortable. It's Mr. Wiggles. I don't know how we're going to explain this to the board. It's Mr. Wiggle! Oh. Oh, this is so good. Top six answers on the board. We asked 100 men, if you were dating a stripper, what might you tell your parents she did for a living?
Eat.
She eat.
She's a dancer.
She's a dancer, yeah. We talked to 100 men. If you're dating a stripper, what might you tell your parents that she do for a living?
I'm gonna go with waitress, Steve.
She's a waitress. Yeah. Bring stuff to you. Dwayne, you dating a stripper, what might you tell your parents she did for a living?
She's an actress.
She's an actress, yeah. That's right. Amanda, 100 women, you dating a stripper, what might you tell your parents she did for a living?
She's a sexy nurse.
She's a nurse. Marty, if you were dating a stripper, what might you tell your parents she did for a living?
Singer.
She's a singer. All right, Corby, we got two strikes. You need to be careful now. Taylors can steal.
She's an athlete.
She's an athlete. We asked 100 men, if you were dating a stripper, what might you tell your parents she did for a living?
She's a teacher, Steve.
She's a teacher. Number six.
Bartender.
Four. No, you can't tell that to you. You can't, you cannot tell your mama you're dating a stripper. You can't say that to your mama. You can't, huh?
I can tell my mama.
You can tell your mama what?
My girl's a stripper.
Yeah. Yeah. Is your mama here? No, see, that's what I thought. Number three. Point values are triple. Top four answers on the board, here we go. Name something in the kitchen a wife might hit her husband with.
Frying pan.
Frying pan.
We are gonna play.
They're gonna play.
Sorry, hon. Sorry.
It's amazing, Chris, how you jumped right on that one with the number one answer. Well, John? Looks like your wife knows this one. Name something in the kitchen a wife might hit her husband with.
About a wooden spoon.
Wooden spoon. Tori, name something in the kitchen a wife might hit her husband with.
I'm gonna say a plate.
A plate. I just want to say I've been hit with everything they've listed so far. All right, Taylor, I'm sorry. Name something in the kitchen a wife might hit her husband with.
I'm gonna go with her hand, herself. She's in the kitchen.
She'll give her hand, herself. She's in the kitchen.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say her hand, herself. She's in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Oh. All right, we got two strikes now. If it's there, we're still alive, Nick, yeah, but we gotta be careful right now. Name something in the kitchen a wife might hit her husband with.
She whips him with the towel.
Yeah!
With the towel. Chris, if I had to have this in anybody's hands, I would feel better about it being in yours.
Mama Conch, here we go.
Name something in the kitchen a wife might hit her husband with.
All right, I'm gonna have to say food.
Good answer! Good answer.
This is for sudden death. There's one answer left on the board. If it's there, your family steals, your family wins the game. But if it's not there, the other family gets to play sudden death. Name something in the kitchen a wife might hit her husband with.
Chair.
A chair! Number three.